Hello students, good morning. I am Prem Gupta, your English teacher. Dear students, in the previous classes we were discussing the story that is the love apple. Dear students, we have discussed the story in detail and I had given the homework to complete the word meaning of this chapter in your notebook. I hope that you all have completed. Dear students, today we will discuss the question answer and other exercises of this chapter. So dear students, open your notebook and book also. Today we will do the question answer. Okay, just see the question. It is given at the page number 36. Just see the question. First question is given here. What was the grandma saying to the Johnny in the story? Okay, in the story the grandma was saying to the Johnny about the tomato. Okay, just see here. Just write down the question, students. Dear students, you will write the question from your book, which is given at the page number 36. I will write the answer only on the board. Okay, after writing the question from the note from your book, you will write the answer from the board. Okay, so first of all, you just put the heading, answer the following question. Okay, answer the following question. Then after you will write the question number A. Okay, I'm writing the answer of that. What is the question? Question is given, what was grandma saying to Johnny in the story? Just write down the question. What was grandma saying to Johnny in the story? Okay, just write down the answer. I'm going to write the answer. Grandma was saying to Johnny. Grandma was saying to Johnny. Johnny. In your book it is given only one, so you will write Johnny. Okay students, grandma was saying to Johnny about tomato in the story. Okay students, just write down the answer. Grandma was saying to Johnny about tomato in the story. Okay students, this is the answer of the question number first A. Okay, just write down the answer. Grandma was saying to Johnny about tomato in the story. Okay, and after completing this answer, just write down the second question, which is given in your book. Okay students, just write down the second question. What is the second question? What did the peddler used to carry? Okay, peddler means sailor, used to carry buttons and thread. Okay students, so just write down the question first. What did the peddler used to carry? And after writing the question, you will write the answer from the board. Okay, answer number B. Question you write from your book, which is given at the page number 36. And after that, after writing the question, you will write the answer from the board. The peddler means sailor, used to carry buttons and thread. Okay students, I am writing here BUTTON. Okay, buttons and thread.
THREAD,
threat.
THREADS.
Okay, student, just write down the answer. The peddler used to carry buttons and thread. This is the answer of question number B. Okay, student, just write down. The peddler used to carry buttons and thread. After completing this answer, you will write the next question, question number C. What is the question number C? What seeds did the peddler give to the mother? Okay, where did he get those seeds? There are two questions mentioned in one question number 3. Question number C. First question is, what seeds did the peddler give to the mother? He gave the seeds of love apple. Okay. And where did he get those seeds? He get those seeds from the city. Okay, students. So write the question first. After completing the question, you will write the answer. Okay. First of all, you complete the answer number B. Then write down the question number C. Then after, you will write the question answer number C. Okay, students. After completing the question from your book, you will write the answer of question number C. What is the question number C? The question number C is, what did the peddler give the mother? And the another thing is there, where did he get those seeds? Okay, write down the answer. The peddler gave some love apple seed. Love apple seeds. Love apple seeds to the mother. M-O-T-H-E-R. He got those seeds in the city. From where he got those seeds? Okay, students, just see the answer. There are two questions mentioned in one question. Okay, the answer of first is, the peddler gave some love apple seeds to the mother. Okay, the another part of the answer is, he got those seeds in the city. Okay, he got those seeds in the city. Okay, students, just write down this answer. And after completing this answer, you will write the question number D. What is question number D? Yes, see, students, question number D. What did the peddler warn the mother about the seed? He warned the mother about the seed that it is poisonous. Okay? It gives the poisonous fruits. That is known as love apple. Okay? So this is the answer. First of all, you complete this answer, answer number C. Then after you will write the question number D from your book, then answer of that question. Okay, students, I hope that you all have written these two answers, answer number A and B. So I'm going to erase it. Answer number B and A. And just write down the question number D. And after writing the question, you will write the answer. Okay? Just see. What is question? Question number D. What did the peddler warn the mother about the seeds? The peddler warned the mother
the peddler. Warn the mother. The peddler warned the mother that although the flowers are small. Although the flowers are small, but the fruits, comma, here you will use the comma, but the fruits, F-R-U-I-T-S, but the fruits cannot be eaten as fruit. F-R-U-I-T-S. As they are poisonous. Poisonous. Okay, students. So this is the answer of the question number D. Just write down the answer. The peddler warned the mother that although the flowers are small, but the fruits cannot be eaten as fruit, as they are poisonous. Who warned? The peddler warned. Okay. The peddler warned the mother that although the flowers are small, but the fruits cannot be eaten as fruits, as they are poisonous. Okay, students, so just write down the answer. Answer number D. And after completing this answer, you will write the question. After completing the answer number D, you will write the question number E. What is question number E? What happened when the mother planted the seeds? Okay, students, after completing this answer, you will write the question. What happened when the mother planted the seeds? Okay. So just write down the answer. Answer number D. I am going to erase the answer number C. I hope that you all have written the answer number C. Dear students, if you have any kind of problem related to the topics, related to the chapter number 4, you can ask in the comments or you can also ask in the WhatsApp group. Okay, just see, write down the question number E from the book which is given at the page number 36. Okay, after completing this answer question, you will write the answer. What was the question? What happened when the mother planted the seeds? Just write down the answer. When mother planted, when mother planted the seeds, they grew and little yellow blossoms. Blossoms means flower. Okay, B-L-O-S-S-O-M-S. Little yellow blossoms came
which grew into red fruits.
Which grew? G-R-E-W, grew into red fruits. Into red fruits. R-U-I-T-S. Okay, students?
So just write down the answer. When the mother planted the seeds, they grew and little yellow blossoms came, which grew into the red fruits. Okay, students? So this is the answer of the question number E. You will write it in your notebook. In this way, we have completed the question answer of the chapter number 4. Okay, students, in your notebook, you have to write only the word meaning and question answer. And other exercises we will fill in the book only. Okay, no need to write the other exercises in the notebook. In the notebook, you will write only word meaning and question answer of the chapter. Okay, students, so just complete these question answer in your notebook. And after completing this question answer, you will open the book. Okay, just open the book, page number 36. First of all, we will discuss the learning words. Okay? Just see the learning words. Okay, students, I am going to erase this answer. I hope that you all have written. Okay? You can also take the screenshot. Okay, students, just see the first question, learning words. Dear students, first of all, we will discuss the learning words. Learning words. This is the exercises. Exercise in which you have to do what you have to do. It is given, page number 36. Make the nouns given below into countable by adding one of the phrase given in the box. Here you have to make the countable noun by adding the phrase which is given in the helping box. In the helping box, given a drop, a piece, a pinch, a packet, a seat, a heap. Okay, that is helping box. That is the phrase, you can say. And you have to make the countable nouns. Countable nouns means, students, the noun which can be counted. जिसे गिना जा सकता है, इसे count किया जा सकता है, उसे countable noun कहते हैं. Okay? But here, we will use the phrase that is not countable noun. There are so many words that is not countable noun. Okay? But here used as a countable noun because here some phrases are given. Okay, a drop. We can count a drop. We cannot count the water, but we can count the drop. One drop, two drop, three drop. Okay, in such a way. A piece. Okay, a pinch, a packet, a seat, a heap. These are the options given. And question is given here. You can see in your book that you have to fill, blank is given. In the blank, you have to fill the suitable, appropriate word from the box, from the helping box. Okay, students, we will see the question, learning words. You see here, first question is given. There is a blank. A sound. Second question is what? Of sugar. Third question, question number C is given, of paper. Okay, question number D is given, of sand. S-A-N-D. Question number E, what is E? Of water. Of water. And the last question, question number F is given, what? Of music. Music. M-U-S-I-C. Okay, students, just see here. Option is already given here. So with the help of help box, you will try to fill. Here in the first blank you will fill a pinch of salt. Pinch matlab chutki, chutki bharna ma. A pinch of salt. Yes, P-I-N-C-H. You will fill in the first blank a pinch of salt. And another sugar, half sugar. Blank, you can see from the helping box. What would be the suitable? A packet of sugar. Okay, a packet. P-A-C-K-A-T. A packet of sugar. Okay, P-A-C-K-A-T. A packet of sugar. Okay, next question. A paper. Okay, a piece. Question number C. A sheet of paper. Okay, students, just fill here. A sheet of paper. Okay, a sheet of paper. In the question number D, sand. Sand. A heap of sand. Heap means dheer. Okay, a heap. A heap of sand. Just see the next question. A drop of water. Here we will fill a drop. A drop of water. And here we will fill the a piece of music. P-I-E-C-E. Okay, students. So all these options already given in the helping box. You may take the help from the help box. And so the correct sentence will be a pinch of salt. Okay, a packet of sugar. A sheet of paper. A heap of sand. A drop of water. A piece of music. Okay, students. So this is these things you will fill in the blank. Okay, in the first blank you will fill a pinch. In the second, question number B, you will fill a packet. In the question number C, you will fill the word a sheet. In the question number D, a heap. In the question number E, a drop. In the question number E, a piece. Okay, students. So in this way, we have completed the exercise helping verb. So students, today we have completed the question answer of the chapter 4, as well as we have completed the learning words of the chapter given at the page number 36. Okay, students, in the next class, we will discuss the other exercises of the same chapter. Okay, students, that's all for today. Thank you.